And the LGBT community knows this all too well. LGBT community knows this all.
오늘은 게이나 레즈비언 혹은 호모라고도 불리는 성소수자에 관한 영어 표현에 대해서 알아보도록 하겠습니다. 코리아 중앙데일리 컬처 에디터 브롤리 젠스터와 함께 하겠습니다. 아, 성소수자는 영어로 하면은 섹슈얼 마이너리티가 될 거고요. 동성애자는 homosexual이 될 건데 실제로 영어 신문에서는 그렇게 잘 안 쓰더라고요.
Yeah, right. In many Western countries, it is more common to use the phrases LGBT or LGBTQ. LGBTQ is an acronym. So L stands for lesbian, G is for gay, B is for bisexual, T is for transgender, and Q is for queer or questioning. Both terms are generally accepted.
그러면 내가 동성애자다 이렇게 얘기할 때는 I'm LGBTQ 이렇게 얘기하면 되는 거예요?
Well, this acronym is meant to be inclusive of all different sexual identities. So it's not likely that a person would say I am LGBTQ. It's more used to describe the community as a whole. Similar to the phrase of 성소수자 in Korean or sexual minority, it's similar to that.
근데 요즘에는 LGBTQ 말고도 LGBTQ 플러스라는 말도 쓰던데 그거는 무슨 뜻이에요?
Right. So there's a lot of different sexual identities and it's sometimes very difficult to remember. But yeah, there's other acronyms. There's LGBTQIA and in that acronym the I stands for intersex.
Intersex people are born with sex traits that don't really fit the typical definition of male or female.
A is for asexual, which is used for those who don't feel a sexual attraction to any gender identity. But it can be confusing, and a lot of people don't always remember the correct order to put letters in. So there's been a movement for people to use the phrase LGBTQ+, so that it's kind of inclusive of everybody, but you don't have to remember all of the different letters.
이성애자는 헤테로섹슈얼이라고 알고 있는데,
right.
나 이성애자다 할 때는 I'm heterosexual 이렇게 얘기하면 돼요?
Heterosexual is correct. It's not wrong. But to be honest, it sounds kind of medical or academic. More commonly, people will say the phrase straight. So I am straight.
동성애 축제를 대체로 퀴어 문화 축제라고 하잖아요?
Yes, queer is kind of become similar to LGBTQ, a kind of a blanket term to refer to the community as a whole. So you can say the LGBTQ community, you can also say the queer community. Originally the word queer means to be different or to be outside of the norm, and in the past it was used as an insult or even a slur towards people in the LGBT community. But more recently the community has tried to reclaim or take back the word queer and turn it into a positive. So these days it's common to use queer or even as an identity, I am queer, for people who don't, you know, feel straight and don't necessarily line up with gay or lesbian. You can say I am queer. And outside of Korea, it is common to be called a pride festival or a pride parade. The first pride parade was held in 1970 and it was to commemorate the first anniversary after the Stonewall riots, which happened in June 1969. In June 1969, the Stonewall Inn, which is a gay bar in New York City, was raided by police. While it was not the first time that a gay bar was raided by police in New York City, it was the first time that the patrons fought back against the police. And it's widely considered in American kind of gay rights history to be one of the most important events in the gay rights movement.
동성애나 성소수자를 상징하는 게 그 레인보우잖아요. 레인보우 깃발이 항상 그런 그 행사에 등장하고요. 왜 레인보우 깃발을 사용하게 된 거예요?
Yes, so the rainbow flag is what we call it in English, and it has a pretty interesting history. It was designed in 1979 by an artist from San Francisco whose name is Gilbert Baker. Mr. Baker was asked to design the flag by a very famous queer activist named Harvey Milk, who was the very first openly gay man elected to public office in California. The flag was designed to be an emblem of empowerment and be able to be used to represent the entire community as a whole. And it has six colors. Originally it had eight, but these days it has six. And each color has a meaning. Red is life, orange is healing, yellow is sunlight, green is nature, blue is harmony, and purple is spirit.
오늘은 성소수자, 동성애에 대한 영어 표현을 알아봤습니다. 아, 섹슈얼 마이너리티나 호모섹슈얼이란 말은 잘 안 쓰고요. LGBT, LGBTQ, 혹은 LGBTQ 플러스라고 합니다. 1969년 미국 뉴욕의 한 게이 바에서 벌어진 충돌 사건을 계기로 미국에서도 게이 인권 운동이 본격화되는데요. 다음 해인 1970년부터 프라이드 퍼레이드라고 해서 성소수자들의 권리를 증진하기 위한 축제가 열렸습니다. 올해로 50주년이 됐고요. 우리나라에서는 퀴어 문화 축제라고 해서 열리고 있는데 올해로 20주년이 됐습니다. 퀴어라는 말은 원래는 이상한이라는 뜻이었는데 성소수자들이 자신들을 지칭하는 용어로 긍정적으로 승화시켜서 사용하고 있습니다. 이것으로 오늘 순서를 마치겠습니다. 감사합니다.